And we are here on the Hudson, and I'm here visiting again with Roger Seiler. It's all about the water, and basically, Alexander Baranov was a shipbuilder, but not on purpose. Let's talk about his sailing abilities.
Well, he did learn how to sail eventually, but it was a real struggle because the Russian sailors didn't want to teach him. That was their province of information that they just weren't going to share with Baranov till an Englishman came over, and then the Englishman taught him how to sail.
And once he learned how to sail, he realized one of the problems he had to solve was that it took a year for the ships to get there when they got there for his supplies. So he figured he needed more ships. Then what'd he do?
Yeah, because a third of the ships were sinking. So he figured with that many going down, he better start making ships in Alaska. So he built the Phoenix, which was the first ship built on the west coast of North America, and built with what he had to work with there. I mean, he made nails from scrap iron that was laying around from wrecked ships and so on, and he used local timber, and he was able to do it with the help of this Englishman, who really didn't want to stick around to do that. And so they had an argument and a fist fight, and Baranov won. So the Englishman stayed and helped him build the ship.
Well, you'll get that ship one way or the other.
That's right.
Well, again, it's the fascinating thing about Baranov is that he was indeed a problem solver. He never took anything that was not able to that came up, from building a ship to feeding his people to anything. He just solved those problems.
That's right. And he got the reputation then in the early 1800s around the world as the world's greatest problem solver. And a part of the reason that this story spread so much is because the Russian sailors, as they were sailing around the world, would tell the story of Baranov and all of his accomplishments and all of the problems he had to solve. And of course, these stories got bigger and bigger and bigger the further they sailed. So.
Well, I guess that's a sailor's way of just telling a tale.
Well, yes, and of course, their standing among the other sailors depended on who told the tallest tale.
Well, we're grateful that he told them that those tales were told. We're grateful that you wrote this book, and I'm telling you, it is a page-turner, wonderful, fun book to read.
Well, I'm glad you enjoyed it, and I hope that many more people will, too.
And you have been in the DM Zone. Come back soon.
Hi there, I'm Roger Seiler, the author of this historical novel, Master of Alaska. And you can go on to Amazon.com and order it in either the paper or their ebook format. And after you've read it, we'd love to hear from you. So please enter your comments on Amazon, and we'll be looking forward to seeing what you have to say. Thank you.